Hello everyone, welcome to Soka Xtra. Tonight we have some great stories lined up for you. We have the 2013 PNGFA activities preview. Then we look at a story on the Just Pay program makes a breakthrough to the Teteh community. And to wrap up the show, we look at a young woman who represents the country in soccer, has decided to give back to the little ones in her community, her experience. But before all that, Soka Xtra would like to bring you back to 2013 and show you some activities PNGFA has accomplished. Enjoy. The Australian government-funded Just Pay program has been breaking barriers to be the first sports for development program to make a breakthrough to the Teteh community, which was known to be a no-go zone in Port Moresby. Let's join Leo Jakando as he brings you more on that.
Last Saturday, the Just Pay team visited the Teteh community in Garo, which is known as a no-go zone in Port Moresby, to have fun with kids using football as a tool to address issues affecting them.
You know, as we all know, Teteh is not a good place, as people would say. For me coming here, I was a little bit scared, but I made a commitment to come here and I want to be part of a change. And I'm so impressed to see the kids out here with their parents, and I see a lot of youths here, and I've interviewed a couple of them who are happy to help with this program. And I'm glad that Just Play came into Teteh, and I hope to see a lot of changes in this community.
The community has a reputation for illegal activities, but this will now be a thing of the past with the introduction of Just Play, a football program to engage the children, giving them the opportunity to excel in life. The struggle for a better life is apparent just by looking at the Teteh community youngsters. Most of them aren't schooling for obvious reasons.
No, I just like I don't help him. Let me play here, but now it's like Just Play program. Come and listen, me play. Now me pass away how to play soccer.
Just Play is a part of the Pacific Sports Partnership program, which is funded by the Australian government. Focuses on using football to support broader social development in youth through design football-related activities. Children also learn to develop healthy lifestyle habits, encourage gender equality, promote social inclusion, insist on sports for all, and become confident in their abilities.
Once on beginning grow up time, thinking problem open or kissing or something, I put him going chill or thinking problem na all babian him. So this place can all socialize something awesome. People can come inside. I mean big something to us.
With a sizzling pot must be hit, the Teteh community oval went up in dust, with enthusiastic football learners who braved the heat, eager to show their skills. Just Play is the first sports development program to make a breakthrough, and the community gratefully welcomes further development.
Welcome back. Growing up in a community where it is the hub of criminal activities, Lavinia Hola has been the role model to the little ones in her community in representing PNG in the women's football. Lavinia has now decided to share her experience with the little ones in Teteh to make a change in the community. Let's find out more on that.
As a young girl growing up at Teteh community and representing PNG in soccer, Lavinia Hola is making a stand to share experience with the little ones in a community.
As now we come up as a PNG rep, like I want to give it back to my people a lot because where I'm like grow up here. So me like you go back and like 6 to 12, like me like the experience for me go back low. So one day like a rapid country, like it's named Lomi Platetea. Because plenty of line outside, so talk me plot Teteh, the West is rascal, me plus a stapa. So me plus so him line with him. Now we are changed.
Lavinia is currently in training with the senior women's soccer team, preparing for the 2015 Pacific Games. Lavinia, who comes from the Gulf province, is the youngest in a family of four and has proven herself representing the country early this year for the OFC Under-20 Championships in New Zealand. Lavinia idolizes her mom, who once played for the Guria Soccer Club in Port Moresby as a midfielder. Last year, Lavinia plays a defender for the Munkas Football Club in Port Moresby. No doubt, Lavinia will definitely go a long way with her skills and passion for football as she grows up. The youngest daughter of former footballer Beverly, Lavinia started playing football in her childhood days at Teteh Community Oval after observing her mom taking part in the Garawu country. From the dusty Teteh Community Oval, Lavinia was identified and got selected for the first time to attend training sessions for the under-15 qualifiers in 2010, which was staged in New Zealand. Committing herself to training paid off when she joined fellow teammates to play in New Zealand. This was the breaking point for her. In 2012, she represented the country once more for the OFC under-17 qualifier in New Zealand. And from there on, she never looks back, which the rest is history in making for this young Keremales. Lavinia now involves herself with Just Play to teach young ones in a community to use football as a driving force to change Teteh, which was known as a no-go zone. The 18-year-old is now eyeing a spot in the senior women's squad for the Pacific Games next year in Port Moresby.
Thanks for watching. That's all for tonight. See you all next week at the same time, same station, MTV. To get more information and updates of football in the country, log on to www.pngfootball.com.pg. We would like to thank all our sponsors for supporting us in developing football in the country. From the Soka Xtra crew and PNGFA, good night.